Hello, welcome back to Learn Physics. In today's topic, we are continuing with our electromagnetic induction. In last video, we learned till about the self-inductance. Today, we are going to study about mutual induction. Mutual induction. What is meant by mutual induction? In self-induction, we were learning about the development of an induced EMF in the same in the coil itself, isn't it? But in the case of mutual induction, we will be considering two coils. See, here I am considering a coil which is connected with a cell. Okay, and here I am considering another coil which is connected with a galvanometer. Okay, so here the current is passing through this coil. When I am switching on, what will happen? Current will pass through this coil. Okay, that is, while I am switching on, current is increasing. While it is increasing, magnetic flux also will be changing, or magnetic flux will be inducing. Okay, this will cause an EMF in the other coil. So if I am considering this as A and this as B, this will be causing an EMF in the other coil. Okay, so EMF developed in this coil will be opposing the direction of current in the other coil. Okay, flux is increasing. While flux is increasing, what will happen? A change in flux is causing an EMF will be induced in this coil. This EMF will be opposing the direction of increase of current. See, if it is increasing the current, EMF will be opposing the increase in current. Okay, so this is called a mutual induction. That means flux linked with one coil changes, which gives an induced EMF in the other coil, which opposes the increase in the first coil, increase in current in the first coil. It is the property by virtue of which, it is the property between two coils by virtue of which, if current linked with one of the circuit is changing, then which will cause an induced EMF in the other coil, which opposes the increase in current in the first coil. Okay, so the current is increasing in this coil, so that causes a change in flux. That change in flux will be giving an EMF in the other coil. It will get deflected when we are switching it on. Okay, the galvanometer will get deflection. What is the reason for that deflection? Because an EMF is inducing in the current in the coil. Why? Because a changes magnetic flux linked with the circuit is changing. Okay, an EMF is inducing in this coil. So here what will happen? This EMF will be opposing the increase in the current in the other coil. In the same way, while we are taking out, what will happen? Current will be decreasing. Here an EMF will be developing. That EMF will be opposing the decrease in current. That means it will be helping it to increase the current. That means decay of loss of current. See, when it is coming to zero, when current is coming to zero, it is the time will be increasing to come to zero. Okay, so the time required to become I is equal to 0 will be decreasing. That means it is opposing the decrease in current in the other coil. Okay, this property is called as mutual induction. So when current linked with, when we are considering the property of two coils by virtue of which, if current in one of the coils changes, an EMF will be induced in the other coil, which opposes the increase in or decrease in the current in the previous coil. Okay, understood? So this is mutual induction. Now the flux linked with the circuit is directly proportional to the current, isn't it? So phi is equal to M into I, mutual inductance. M is called as mutual inductance, or we can say if I equals 1 ampere, then phi is equal to M. That is, mutual inductance between the two coils is equal to the flux linked with the second coil, because if 1 ampere of current is flowing through the circuit. Okay, unit of mutual inductance is Henry. In self-inductance also, Henry only, here also Henry. Okay, Henry is the unit of mutual inductance. And we know E is equal to minus d phi by dt. Isn't it? So, if we are substituting this mi value over here, we will get it as d by dt of mi, or we can write it as minus m into di by dt. Or we can write it as, how we can define mutual inductance using this equation, E is equal to minus m into di by dt. If di by dt equals 1 ampere per second, then E is equal to m. Mutual inductance of the circuit will be equal to the, or between the two coils is equal to the EMF induced in the second coil if the rate of current in the first coil is 1 ampere per second. Okay, so this is how also we can define mutual inductance. So mutual inductance phi is equal to MI. Using this equation also we can define, how we can define, see, mutual inductance is equal to the flux linked with the other coil if 1 ampere current is flowing through the first coil. 1 ampere current is flowing through the first coil, which will be causing an induced EMF in the second coil. This property is called, which is opposing the increase in current. This property is known as mutual inductance. Okay, so phi is equal to mi. So phi is equal to m when 1 ampere current is passing through the first coil. Okay, clear? So how we are finding out the unit of mutual inductance is Henry. Clear for you? Next, we are finding out mutual inductance of two long coaxial solenoid. Coaxial means same axis, on one over the other, like that it will be kept. That is coaxial. Axis is same. Okay. Here I am considering two solenoids, S1 and S2 are the two solenoids. L1 is the length of the conductor. Here also L1. Same length I am considering, so I can consider it as L. I1 is the current flowing through the first one, and I2 is the current, while I am considering, and we will consider as I2 is the current flowing through the second one. Okay, so now I am considering only in the second coil current is flowing. So no need to consider about the first coil, we are not taking any current in the second coil. So first coil, so here only, in the first coil only, which will be developing? Yes, mutual inductance will be developing in the first coil, because I2 is the current flowing through the second one. Okay, A1 is the area of cross section, and here area of cross section is A2, and R1 is the radius over here, and R2 is the radius over here. Okay, now current is inducing in this second coil. While we are giving current in the second coil, what will happen? A flux will be changing in the first coil. Okay, so in the second coil we are giving a current. Okay, so magnetic flux linked with the second coil is, first coil will be changing. Okay, I2 is, we are giving a current over here, which will give a change in flux in the first coil. Okay, flux is changing in the second coil also, and that change in flux will be affecting the coil of first coil, and which will give an induced EMF in the first coil. Okay, here because of electric current, flux is developing, and that change in flux will be giving induced EMF in the first coil also. Now we are going to find out the change in flux. How we can find out the flux? BA, B dot A. isn't it? Since they both are on the coaxial, we can consider it as 0. Cos 0 will be 1. So here, phi 1, flux in the first one. Here, what is the flux developed? The same flux will be developing over here also, because magnetic flux is changing over here. So flux linked with the circuit which is changing in the first coil is equal to phi. How we can find out? BA. Why from where we are getting the magnetic field? Magnetic field because of the current in the second one. So here B2. Flux is developing in which coil? First coil. So A1. Okay, and how many number of turns are there? See, here we are considering N1 is the number of turns in per unit length. Number of turns per unit length. And the same way here consider N2 is the number of turns per unit length. Okay, here capital N1 is the total number of turns. Total turns. And here capital N2 is the total number of turns. Okay, so here for one turn, it is magnetic field is developing in the second coil and area is flux is happening for which coil? First coil, isn't it? So it is A1. Area we should consider that one. And here I am considering the number of turns per unit length, N1 into L. So B2 into pi R1 square N1 into L. Okay, now this is flux. Flux we know it is mutual inductance of the first coil with respect to the second coil. Because of second coil, mutual inductance is developing. Phi is equal to M1 into I2 because current is in the second coil. So here we can consider, so while we are considering these two equations, we can equate the right hand side. I will get it as M12 into I2, that is equal to B2 pi R1 square N1 into L. Now we should find out B2. What is the value of B2 here? B2 is equal to B equals, how we can find out B? B is equal to mu 0 N2 I. Okay, that is B0 N2 into I. So here we will consider it as M12 I2 equals, here also I2, mu 0 N2 I2 pi R1 square N1 into L. Okay, here I2 and I2 will get cancelled. So we will get it as mu 0 N1 N2 pi R1 square into L. Okay, this is the mutual inductance of the first coil with respect to the second coil. Clear how we are getting this equation? So M12 equals mu 0 N1 N2 pi R1 square into L. Okay, in the same way we can find out the mutual inductance of second coil with respect to the first coil. This one we are going to find out. You just tell me, now I am giving I1 current. So flux linked with the second coil will be equal to D dot A, isn't it? So D, magnetic field is developing in which coil? First coil. And what is the area behind it? See, I am considering S1 and S2, two coaxial solenoids, isn't it? So one coil is like this and inside this I am considering another small coil. Okay, so the radius of this coil is R1 and the radius of this coil is R2. Radius of this coil is R2, bigger one is R2 I am considering. So while I am considering this one, if current is flowing through this coil, what will be the flux area of flux inside the coil? Here current will be developing in this much coil only, isn't it? So we should consider the area of this solenoid, small solenoid. Why? Because current is flowing in this coil, so that much of flux only will be developed, isn't it? Flux linked with this much of circuit only will be changing, right? Here current is not there. Okay, in the previous case, even if flux was here also, we considered only in the small coil. Why? Because flux is acting on that coil. Here, current is developing in the small coil, and outside that a bigger coil is there. We are considering the mutual inductance of the second coil. Then also, flux is not reaching it. It is solely inside the first coil. So we should consider here also as A1 only. And what is the total number of turns of the coil? N2 into L. Okay, so how we can find out B1? B1, what is the formula? Mu 0 N1 into I1. Okay, so phi 2 we can write it as M 2 1, mutual inductance of the second coil with respect to first coil into I1, that is equal to mu 0 n1 I1, A1 I can write it as pi R1 square N2 into L. So here I1 and I1 will get cancelled, so we will get it as M21 equals mu 0 n1 N2 pi R1 square L. So here this is M21 and this is M12, that is mu 0 n1 n2 pi r1 square a by l into l. Here M21 also mu 0 n1 n2 pi r1 square by l. So from this we can understand that mutual inductance of second coil with respect to first coil will be equal to mutual inductance of first coil with respect to the second coil. M12 is equal to M21. So how is it possible? Why? Because here you should consider the current in the first coil as well as the second coil. If current is passing through the first coil, an EMF will be developed in the second coil. Okay, if second coil current is passing, mutual inductance will be developed in the first coil. Okay, clear? So usually this numbering, if you are not understanding that properly, this one will you will go wrong. Okay, so here you should understand that flux linked with the coil. Which coil flux is linked? Because of the current, change in current, a magnetic field is developing in that, and that magnetic field is affecting the first coil only, isn't it? So flux linked with the first coil will be equal to, because of the magnetic field developed in the second coil because of current. Okay, magnetic field into area. Where flux we are considering? In the first coil we are considering the flux. So the area of that one into the total number of turns. Okay, clear? So this is how we will be finding out the mutual inductance of two long coaxial solenoids. Clear for you? So here in this chapter only a small portion is left out, that is AC generator. That one we will consider in the next class. Okay, so I hope all of you understood all those things, and if you like the channel, please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. Bye.